When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag.
When I get older, I will. My name is Peter Lee, and I just experienced the semester of a lifetime as a participant of the NUN Greece program. When I first opened up my letter of acceptance from Northeastern University, I was ecstatic because Northeastern was one of my top college choices. As I continued to read the letter and realized I was accepted into the NUN program, I was a bit confused and drawn back. I knew I wanted to go to college in a large city such as Boston, but never did I imagine studying abroad my first semester. The more I read about the program, however, the more interested I became, and I quickly realized that this was the perfect opportunity to travel to Europe for the first time in my life. I selected Thessaloniki as my NUN location because of its prime position in Eastern Europe. Whenever I told my friends and family members that I would be studying in Greece, I always received mixed emotions in return. Some people would say that they were so envious of my opportunity, while others would ask whether it was safe due to the protests and riots sparked by the economic crisis. As a business major, I was really looking forward to being able to learn firsthand how the economic crisis has affected the Greeks, rather than just reading about it in newspapers. I was unsure of my initial feelings towards Greece as I traveled through Thessaloniki streets for the first time. I was expecting to see beautiful European-style architecture and history all over the place, but reality hit me when I saw graffiti everywhere I looked, as well as many unmaintained buildings. When I walked the streets of the city, I saw stray dogs everywhere. When I say everywhere, I literally mean everywhere. This was not the Thessaloniki I'd seen in Google Images, and I was unsure if I would ever feel at home here. It took me some time to adjust to the cultural differences between America and Greece. I knew absolutely no Greek whatsoever, and the language barrier was one of the biggest challenges. Greek food was very different compared to American food, to say the least. Greek Orthodox churches were everywhere because religion and Greek culture are so intertwined. The more time I spent in Thessaloniki, however, the more I learned to embrace and adjust to the cultural differences. I learned in Greek class how to make basic conversation with Greeks. I began to try new Greek food and learned to enjoy gyros, souvlaki, and tzatziki. I even found a Roman Catholic church that made myself feel more at home in Greece. I spent the majority of my time at the American College of Thessaloniki and the Metropolitan Hotel. ACT is a very quiet and rural campus, and all of my classes had under 25 students in them. The Metropolitan Hotel was located in the heart of downtown Thessaloniki and was just a 10-minute bus ride away from Aristotle Square. I tried to experience as much of Thessaloniki as possible by doing something different every weekend, such as attending the annual Festival of Colors, taking a 4-hour bike ride through the countryside, and attending two PAOK soccer games versus their rivals, RS and Olympiacos, where I will never forget watching the passionate PAOK fanatics. While I was able to participate in many of Thessaloniki's activities, I was also able to spend my time volunteering at the U.S. College Counseling Office in Anatolia College, where they guide Greek high school students through the entire U.S. college application process. I worked with the counselors by researching colleges in the United States that would be suitable for the students of Anatolia College. We spent a large amount of time planning a college fair, where the juniors were able to acquire information about various colleges. It was interesting to learn just how different it is for Greek students to apply to college as opposed to American students. These Greek students must find colleges that their family can afford, which is especially difficult for them due to this economic crisis, and because the government does not give financial aid for students to study in America. The crisis has caused so many people to give up on their dreams of studying in America and forced them to stay at home in Greece. My time at the U.S. College Counseling Office really made me realize how privileged I am to be an American student where education is such a high priority. I enjoyed spending my time helping out the college counselors and being able to at least make a small impact on the lives of the prospective U.S. college students. It's one thing to say that I lived in Greece for 3 months, but it's another thing to say that I actually made my time worthwhile by participating in service learning and making a positive difference in the community. While I've made many great memories as a part of the NUN Greece program, my favorite experiences have been traveling and being able to see various parts of the world. As an 18-year-old student, I have visited more places than I could have ever imagined. With the NUN program, I traveled to Athens and saw the Parthenon, went to many Greek historical sites such as Vergina and Delphi, and hiked to the peak of Mount Olympus, the highest mountain in all of Greece. I have been to Rome, where I saw beautiful Italian landmarks such as the Colosseum, Trevi Fountain, and Pantheon, and visited the Vatican, where I witnessed the astonishing architecture of St. Peter's Basilica. I also traveled to Bologna and Milan, where I ate the most delicious Italian food of my life and watched an intense Inter Milan soccer game. My overall experience from the NU in Greece program has been very positive. While it took me some time to adjust to my new surroundings, I can finally say that I was eventually able to call Thessaloniki my home. Just because there may be a cultural difference between the American and Greek lifestyles does not mean that one culture is better than the other. A man once said, "When overseas, you learn more about your country than you do the place you're living." I have learned so much about Greece, yet at the same time I have learned how grateful I am to live in the United States. I hope that in the future I will have another opportunity to study abroad, where I can continue to broaden my horizon in my attempt to become a citizen of the world.